Ant-Man issue 2 sees the three Bugmen Vesper, Thread, and Tusk confront Ant-Man and Swarm, who tell Scott that the three beings crave death and destruction, and he needs the hero to stop them. Scott says that he will fight the Bugmen, but not for the Nazi villain, as he is attacked by Thread. The villains demand that Scott give him Swarm, as they try and smash the Nazi villain, but Scott pushes him out of the way. He reminds Scott that he is made of bees, and he would have been just fine if they hit him. Scott thinks that shrinking will help him battle the villains, but they send out waves upon waves of stag beetles, which pinch Scott and make him return to normal size. He tells Swarm they need to run, and Scott finds the bee that led them there, telling him that he needs some help, and thanks to Scott aiding him in finding his brothers, the bee offers some help, showing them the way out of the catacombs. As they make it out, Scott enlarges the bee, using the huge insect's thorax to block up the hole to the hive. Scott apologizes to him, but the bee is more than happy to help as Scott confronts Swarm, demanding to know what he has gotten him into. Swarm tells him to get comfortable, since this will take some explaining. Meanwhile in Miami, Cassie tells her mother that lately Scott has not been taking her or his superhero life seriously, and he's treating her more like a daughter than a partner. Her mother isn't shocked at that, seeing as Cassie is his daughter, but Cassie thinks it's time to stretch her legs, and she can do that thanks to being offered a place on the Avengers. Her mother is happy, but upon learning it is the West Coast Avengers, she says that's not going to happen. Cassie says that Kate Bishop is running the team now, but her mother thinks that that just means anyone can call themselves an Avenger now if Kate Bishop is doing it. Peggy tries to tell Cassie that Scott moved to Miami to be closer to her and loves fighting crime as Ant-Man with Cassie as his stinger, but Cassie reminds her that he lives in an anthill now and he isn't taking life seriously, and maybe she has to leave to know the hero she can truly become. Peggy knows that Cassie needs to tell Scott before she leaves, and Cassie knows, but Scott is busy up north tracking a farmer's bees and not fighting crime. Scott meanwhile learns from Swarm that he was once a Nazi beekeeper who discovered a mutated hive of killer bees that he attempted to weaponize by firing a ray gun he had developed to put the bees under his control, only it increased their aggression, causing the swarm to attack him and consume him. He wasn't the only one, as around the world, the very same mutation was affecting other insects, leading to Vesper, Thread, and Tusk being created. These three beings, however, couldn't maintain a human structure, which displeased the one they call Master. So Swarm was kidnapped and forced to use his ray gun to gift the insects with this power. The plan did not go well, and the insects retained their hive intelligence, making them impure half-breeds, which angered Master, who wanted Swarm killed, but he escaped and found some bees willing to protect him. Soon Scott's bee friend says that he feels strange as his head explodes thanks to all of the controlled bees eating through him from within. The villains soon emerge through the hole, and soon Swarm points out that they aren't alone as Macrothrax, their master, arrives. He looks at the big bee before telling Scott to give him Swarm. Scott says that he is not protecting this Nazi, but he won't be giving him up until he knows what is going on. So Macrothrax says that he knows Scott can talk to bugs, and he is a bug that can talk to man, and he wants to use his power to show Scott what's going on. The being projects a vision of horrific destruction into Scott's mind, showing him a group of bugs destroying the world. Macrothrax says that this is the future he brings and why he needs the bees. Scott knows that this guy is really bad, and the villain realizes that Scott won't be helping him, so he sends his three monster thugs out to attack him. Scott fights back with his pim particles, making one of the beetles that make up Husk grow in size, exploding it. Macrothrax is impressed with Scott's power, demanding that he too have it. He uses his powers on Scott's mind again, learning about the Pym particles. Scott says that his helmet is getting overloaded, so he is forced to shrink himself, passing out from the exertion. Nearby, the beekeepers find all of their bees returning, thinking Scott was successful, but Swarm appears, having rescued Ant-Man, who soon awakens. Swarm tells them that Macrothrax left with the others when they couldn't find him, and they even lost all interest in Swarm as their main target, meaning that Scott is now the main target. Swarm gets ready to leave, saying that he is in Ant-Man's debt and he will never forget him, but Scott tells the Nazi that they aren't friends. Scott asks the beekeepers where his giant ant has gotten to, and one of them says he flew off since they thought that he called him. Scott didn't and wonders where his friend has gotten to, as in a hive, Macrothrax has captured the ant, wanting to know where it comes from. Ant-Man issue 2 really broke open the plot as Scott learns just the scope of the simple bug-related problem he was hired to deal with in Florida is. I really enjoyed the humor of this issue, and the humor that came from Scott having to deal with being teamed up with a Nazi made from bees, with him constantly reminding even the villains of the book that he isn't friends with a Nazi. I thought that was actually quite funny. I'm looking forward to learning more about these mysterious villains as well as the really well-designed Macrothrax. I really like that guy's costume and kind of reminds me of like the bad guys from the Death of the Inhumans book in terms of designs. All in all, I thought this was a really great issue and I'm very excited for the rest of this series. I'm going to give this issue an 8.5 out of 10.